inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault, and that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerged from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First down gets three up to the 28.
So, Charles, you look at this offense. What a start to the season. Five wins without a loss. When do you think that you start believing that maybe you're in the midst of something special?
Well, you and I both know every head coach never wants that thought to creep into a locker room. But the truth of the matter is, not quite at this time, because if we look at the Steelers in 2020, they're a great example. Remember, they started 11-0. Then lost 5 of 6 and went out in the first round. But I think if you get toward mid-November, the Thanksgiving time frame, and you're still doing this, that's when things start to get real for a ball club.
On 2nd and 7, Lance forced out to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were excellent last week in the win over the Chargers.
No matter what coverage was called, they were right in the hip pockets of the receivers all game long, step for step, running their routes with them. Turned out they were right there every time the ball was in the air, and they came away with 5 interceptions in that one.
And that last throw, CD, going to move him even further up that all-time passing leaderboard as he just moved beyond Broadway Joe. Joe Namath at 27,663 yards.
And that's impressive because Joe Namath, my goodness, he could throw a football. I mean, it was just gorgeous the way he threw it. Rallied his Jets to a Super Bowl win, one of the greatest upsets in NFL history. Broadway Joe, the man.
Behind the chains, 2nd and 13. And Lance going to throw. Escaping the pressure right. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And down to the 27-yard line.
Little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, tried to make a big play, and gave up a bigger one instead.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and 1 yard. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. 8th play of this opening drive coming up. This is 3rd down. Lance going to sneak it. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Only a few inches needed on the sneak. He didn't get it, and now it's 4th down. Kyle Shanahan's made the decision. They're going on 4th down. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And the 49ers are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. In lieu of the sneak on 4th and inches, they just say, give it to the big man in the backfield.
Yeah, fullback no less. Not many of those left in the NFL, but for those that have one, perfect time to use them, perfect time to get it done.
And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
A terrible spot for a holding call as they'll try again, but now from further back on 1st and goal. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. A very costly
Wesley Zach there on third and goal, pushes him back big time. And now you figure the field goal team coming on fourth. On second and goal, Lance being chased out left. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
The penalty certainly makes things tougher here as they try again. Third and goal. Now Lance. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And it's complete. In the end zone, touchdown 49ers. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Niners have taken the early lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football for triple option, you've actually called that play.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Nice play call. A little bit of play action right there. If you can get those linebackers to freeze for just a split second, that's usually all the room you need in order to get it to your tight end.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 41. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40. Here's second and 8. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because, really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive is going pretty well. I could come right back at them.
So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
On second and 9, Lance. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Bradley Chubb able to record his fifth sack of the season. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The throw down the field, caught by his running back. Touchdown, 49ers.
Touchdown.
A great effort there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. Extra point right down the middle, and that pushes the lead up to 11. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they come into this one riding that nice long win streak. And remember, next weekend is an open week for them. So if they can get the win here, a lot of momentum into that time off.
It certainly is. And if you're wondering if anybody's saying, boy, this is coming at a bad time, we want to keep playing, the answer can be yes. Because when teams are on a hot streak, they want to keep going. But what the veterans are telling the young guys in the locker room, an open week is always good, guys. Take it, and let's go with it.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, speed is definitely a calling card if you play cornerback in this league, and he does a terrific job there of hustling in quickly to make the play.
And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold him to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
And he only manages a couple here, down to about the 38-yard line.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now a play fake here on first down. Dancing to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Back to throw here. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35.
And that That's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And he wisely will throw that one away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing. Just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
To throw again on second down, Lance. The tight end, Kittle, has it on the left side. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. From midfield, here's Lance. They'll roll him out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. He's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now, look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness has been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that, but I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. Two touchdowns to one interception.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense.
And this is caught. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A big connection on that one. 37 yards. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting 49ers on top. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan. All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Stops short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. They'll look to throw here, eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point, and that's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game I guess he picked a good time to do it.
He certainly did. Not only did he have the element of surprise, he's making sure he's judicious in taking off.
And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
And he will take it across from Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey, his second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is down to four. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change. Because otherwise, that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
Second down and seven. Working from the gun, Lance. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Here's Lance to throw it. And that is incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
A 46-yard punt, 8 yards. On the return, and the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
And it really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well for the defense.
Yeah, what's going on the defensive side?
That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Looking to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And unable to connect, incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
The passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
On as the punt team now as this one sent away. And taken right at the 35. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 39-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
On second and 10, Lance. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and 9, Lance. That's Samuel, caught left side. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Niners on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 6. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's going to get this to the 31, but that is still well short of what he needed. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. He'll look to throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. And some space here. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 51 yards rushing for him now, just 6 carries to this point. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. He gets it forward for 4, maybe 5, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back. Play action. action here on first down.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
I have a few questions about that throw because to me there just wasn't a lot there. I thought he tried to do a little bit too much, almost tried to will a receiver open when there was no chance he was going to be. Nice job by the linebacker being all over that one and knocking it away.
Now a handoff looking right. Only 2 yards on the carry. That's going to set up a third and long, third and 15 to be exact. Now back to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. He's gonna take another shot here. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. 17-17 the score. All even to this point as it kicks away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
Well, we say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally, and that is a big one here in a tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And, Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes, and that was one of our mantras back at Tennessee. Coach Mears used to say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Second and 15. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. A field goal from this spot would be 51 yards. He'll try to move it closer on third down. He'll look to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Going to give this time to the tailback. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no goal. No gain on the play there. Second down. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. Oh, no, he lost the football.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time. Wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And they're facing a big third down now in this tie ball game.
They'll set up a throw.
Touchdown!
It's complete.
A great play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead. They do tack on the extra point as well. And they will take a 7-point lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a 2-minute drill.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. A leap, and he's got it. He got it.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Able to fight through one tackle. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Buying time to his left. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
They'll look to throw. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Once he got out of the pocket, you thought that maybe he'd take off with it, especially here in the 2-minute drill. Sometimes defenses are focused so much downfield that there's room to run, but this time he decided to throw it unsuccessfully.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down.
He'll look to throw, sliding out of the pocket.
And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movements. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got it complete. Now San Francisco going to call their 2nd timeout as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. From the 9, here's 2nd and goal.
Back to throw.
Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Now the Niners going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. On that field, but this is a big play. 3rd and goal.
He's back to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football,
and they just have to make it stand up one more time, because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
Down 7, and they've got to go for it here on 4th down. And they'll go for it. Lance. Flushed out right. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And the Panthers have just about sewn up this football game.
Boy, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, weren't you?
Well, hey, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
Now one final throw here is incomplete, and that is how this one will come to an end. So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And it took a big fourth quarter to do it, but they were able to get the job done, and that's the bottom line.
No doubt about it. And let's face it, they had to be more than nervous in the fourth quarter. But a lot of that was their own doing. I think you observed during the game, their energy level just didn't seem to be there. But in the fourth quarter, somehow they dug deep and found that extra bit, right? That reserve tank. They hauled it out. Offense scored some points. Defense held them. And lo and behold,